worth 4 test. The Worth 4 Light test, also known as the Worth 4 dot test or W4LT, is a clinical test mainly used for assessing a patient's degree of binocular vision and binocular single vision. The Worth 4 Light test is also used in detection of suppression of either the right or left eye. Suppression occurs during binocular vision when the brain does not process the information received from either of the eyes. This is a common adaptation to strabismus, amblyopia and anisocornea. Method of assessment. The Worth 4 light test is relatively simple to undertake. First, you must place the red-green goggles over the patient's eyes, with the red goggles traditionally placed over the right eye. Next, you must dim the room lighting. This allows the patient to see the lights better. For a distance measurement, you should have the patient set up 6 meters away from the light source. For a near measurement, the test should be performed at approximately 1/3 of a meter or 33 centimeters with a handheld Worth 4 light torch. Before the optometrist start to perform interpretation of Worth 4 light test, it is very important not to forget to ask the patient, usually child, a series of questions. These questions are essential and very important to every clinician. How many lights are you seeing? What colors are they? Where are they located? All are the lights in line or are some higher than the others? Do all the lights show up at one time or are they flashing on and off? Interpretation 1. Patient response is 4 light. If patient sees all the 4 lights in the absence of a manifest squint, he has normal binocular single vision. In abnormal retinal correspondence, patient sees 4 lights even in the presence of a manifest squint. Final result is binocular single vision. Second, patient response is 3 green light. If the patient sees only 3 green lights, he has right suppression. Final result is right eye suppression. Third, patient response is 2 red light. When the patient sees only 2 red lights, it indicates left suppression. Final result is left eye suppression. 4. When the patient sees 3 green lights and 2 red lights alternatively, it indicates presence of alternating suppression. Final result is alternate suppression. 5. Patient response is 5 lights. If the patient sees 5 lights, 2 red and 3 green, he has diplopia. Now red image is on patient's right side and green is on left side, means uncrossed images. Final result is uncrossed diplopia. 6. Patient response is 5 lights. If the patient sees 5 lights, 2 red and 3 green, he has diplopia. Now, red image is on patient's left side and green is on right side, means crossed images. Final result is crossed diplopia. 7. Patient response is 5 lights. If the patient sees 5 lights, 2 red and 3 green, the lights are vertically displaced in relation to one another. The red light are on top of the green light. The higher lights belong to the lower eye and the lower lights belong to the higher eye. Final result is vertical diplopia with right hypotropia. If the lights are not situated directly above one another but are also separated horizontally, it is normally indicative of a mixed deviation where there is a horizontal as well as vertical strabismus present. Question for the viewers: what is the interpretation of the given image? Kindly write your answer in the comment box. Thank you for watching. Thank you.